Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? In today's video, we're gonna see how to recreate this Super 8 vintage film look. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed that little intro. I'm a really big fan of the Super 8 look. It just creates an entire vibe, an entire mood that is so different from nowadays cameras. And yeah, it's just a lot of fun to play around with. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to recreate this entire effect. We will be using an assets pack from Smashworks. I will talk about that in a second, but it's just necessary when it comes down to recreating things like that. You do need stock footage and you do need well-prepared assets. And the better these assets are, the better your result is gonna be. And I must say Smashworks really nailed it on that one. So let's have an overview here. Here is the Smashworks website. Where you can see all of their assets that they have created. They spent a lot of hours into making this entire pack so you can achieve everything in a couple of minutes, which is just awesome. You have these hand-painted titles, which look really cool in combination with the vintage film, because a new modern kind of motion graphic wouldn't really work with that. They have plenty of fonts that you can use, the vintage film overlays, which we will be looking at in today's video. Which is also really cool. So let's open up Adobe Premiere Pro and see how to get started. So I will also provide you a simple video clip here, which I just edited together here. I actually went on a Europe trip like 2 weeks back. I went there for 3 weeks. I saw a lot of awesome countries, and I'm also going to be making a travel video for that. I also flew over to IBC. It's gonna be a pretty cool video, I think. So hopefully you'll see that soon. But yeah, so I basically took a few clips here. I just pasted them together. I didn't put too much effort into this, but I did look at like what could work for a vintage film. Okay, so here we have a vintage metro, which fits in a vintage film. So that's also something you have to take care of while filming. Also, everything is handheld. I'm not gonna use gimbals. They didn't have gimbals in the time, so you really don't have to care about the movement. Also, don't think too much about composition. People weren't so obsessed with composition back then. So try to make it look like it's been shot in that time, and then you can replicate it. Also, like for example, this shot is actually not a perfect shot for a Super 8 camera because it has a blurry background and those cameras didn't have that. But anyway, I just wanted to kind of mix the vibe of the old school with the new school. So kind of making a new Neo Super 8. So maybe I just found something new here. So I'm going to drag this in here in my timeline. I'm gonna change the sequence settings. This is a full HD clip. I'm also going to import a song. I actually use this song here from Levito Beats. For those that follow me on, well, for a while now, they know I work very closely with Levito Beats because he has some awesome tracks that you can download. I will put a link in the description if you want to go and check him out. So this song really also helps the vintage a lot. Okay, so what I will do first is go to the sequence settings and change my resolution actually to 1920 to 1440. If I click OK, and that's gonna make it a little bit more vertical, but that's just to prepare it for the pack that we're gonna be using. Another important thing with when it comes down to Super 8 film is that Super 8 film didn't have 24 FPS, 25 or 30 FPS. It was more like a 12 FPS. So the frame rate was a lot slower than nowadays cameras. So what we need to do in order to replicate the effect is to actually cut out some frames. And to do that, what we can do in Adobe Premiere Pro is go to the effects tab here and search for posterize time right here and drag that on your clip. If you go to effects controls right here, you'll see that the current frame rate is set to 24. So we're gonna click on that and set it to 12. And if you're gonna play this back immediately, you can see the frame rate dropping to 12, which is really cool and gives that vintage look. Next thing you want to do is match the colors to older cameras. The most important thing in order to match the colors to a Super 8 is to look at real Super 8 footage and try to narrow it down as precise as possible. That's completely up to you. I'm gonna be showing you a few techniques that I found work well, but of course if I would spend more time on this I would get better results, so that's a job that you will have to do. So what I like to do first is go into the color tab here. And before, when they were shooting with Super 8, when you are in an underexposed shot, you would introduce a lot of noise in your image, and that's not what you want. You want to have an as clean as possible image. So what they did was kind of overexpose it a little bit to get rid of all the noise, but then in the highlights, for example, sometimes on the face, it would be overexposed, the sky is completely blown out. So that's something that you also have to take care of, not to underexpose your shots. But for example, if you have a shot like this, increase the exposure, increase the contrast, decrease the shadows and increase the highlights, kind of getting rid of all the dynamic range that you have in these cameras that makes it so awesome nowadays. But you really wanna kind of make it look blown out. Also the saturation, you can pop it up here. And another important thing is to have an off-white balance, which means not off-white, the terrible brand, but not to have a perfect white balance. So for example, go more into the blues and maybe, or maybe you want to go more to the greens, very subtle. This already looks more vintage, or maybe more to the magenta. I'm going to keep it for magenta now, and also a little bit in the blue, kind of make the image look dirty. Okay, so great. Right here you can see the overexposed area. So that's what we want in the Super 8 look. Next we can go into the creative tab and also play with the sharpen. The footage before wasn't so sharp as nowadays footage, so we really wanna kind of bring that down a bunch, like minus 25, 30, something like that. Okay, great. Then you can play around with these colors over here, or we can actually double click on this and go into the color wheels. I like to work with these a little bit more and introduce, for example, magentas in the shadows, a bunch like red or magenta in between these two, to get these colors here in the shadows. And then we can also introduce maybe some kind of greenish colors. Let's play around a little bit, or maybe more like the orange tones is also pretty cool. And then we can introduce a little bit of green in the highlights. So this looks pretty vintage to me, maybe a little bit too much. Of course, I'm exaggerating for this video. It's up to you to make it subtle and to compare it to real footage, but this looks pretty good. Next thing, I wanna import the vintage film overlay. Well, no, that's actually my example. Here, the frame overlay, that's what I mean. So everything that I'm gonna be using is from Smashworks. I'm going to import that a little bit higher, and we can see currently it's a 4K video, so we should just scale it down a little bit. Let's go back to the edit tab and go to effects controls and scale it down to 50. And there we go. So now we have this awesome look. I'm so in love with it. Cool. So I'm going to hold Alt and drag it over here and then kind of paste it like so. And then we have our entire video clip in our Super 8 aspect ratio. Next, what we want to do is go for the film texture loops. We can play with these as well. But maybe first, let's go for a Super 8 Black HD here. And these are the looks we want to add to this to make it look really cool. So we're going to bring that on top as well. And also scale it down, or actually, I don't know if it should be scaled down. No, 100% is actually good. So now we're going to the blending mode and change it to a lighten or a screen. Play around with these two blending modes. Depending on each scene, it's gonna look a little bit different. I also wanna kind of narrow it down a little bit more. So I will go to the color and I will go to the basic color correction, bring down the blacks, the shadows, and maybe the exposure even, to not get it too obvious, but that looks really cool. Okay, we can go back to the editing now, and I'm going to maybe look at a different one with a little bit more variation. They all look different. For example, we're gonna bring in this one. Oop. And this one, okay. One more. Okay, and we can copy these settings here from the Lumetri color, Control C, and paste it on all of these, and then also change the blending mode of each one to lighten. You can also reuse the first one, they're all loopable, but yeah, I like to add some variation here. Cool. Next, what you want to do is click on your original video clip and hold Alt and drag it up once and twice. We're going to click on one and then just bring it down. You can see that you have this mask over here, which makes it look like it's a film that is currently rolling. Cool. All right, and then we can also offset maybe everything a little bit more to the right. We can, for example, also play with the texture loops. Let's add one texture loop. I'm also gonna bring these just one up. Texture loop to add a little bit more noise, for example. Scale it a little bit. And then set it to screen. Before, after, a little bit more kind of grunge. And there we go. So we also have these burns here that we can use. And these are also really cool. Like before, film always had some kind of glitches in between, some burns, especially on when you did like transitions. So for example, you can add a transition like this and boom, it starts. We can also, and look at my hierarchy of the layers. So first I have my footage, then I have a texture, then I have the frame overlay, and then I have my effect here of the sides. And in between, I have my burn. So really the hierarchy is very important. Try to kind of duplicate it or also play around and make your own thing. It's completely up to you. But like right here, it's an awesome burn. I'm actually gonna make it a little bit shorter and bring it over. Even shorter. And then we have a nice cut like that. Super. Or actually, we have to use it on an actual cut, like right here. Awesome. So these burns really add a lot of details. I also found some sound effects on Epidemic Sound. I will put a link in the description below for Epidemic. Like right here, I have a camera timer, and these sound effects really help a lot, like if you add them in your shot here. And this is, for example, the constant rolling sound effect. I'm going to lower that to like minus 15 in decibels, but having that in the background. If you look at the beginning of this tutorial in the preview, and with these sound effects, you really bring that vibe there. So it's not only visual, but also try to emulate the sound and just make the entire experience like you're watching a video, even in that time. So you're not in 2019 watching a vintage film, you're probably in 1970 watching an old movie. And that's what you wanna have the audience feel, to travel back in time. All right, so basically that's everything you had to do in order to create this entire effect. Last thing that I wanna take a look at is for the graphics here, we have the motion graphics template, which is also from Smashworks, and you can import that just by clicking here and then importing their motion graphics template. And I'm going to be using the hand painted use any font. I'm going to click on that and drag it into my scene here. I'm going to make it shorter and bring it beneath the burn here, so we have that transition from title to actual video. And then we can click on it, make it 50% in size and scale because it's a 4K resolution clip. Now we can rename this Super 8. We can choose a font, we can choose a size, letter spacing. Cool. Change the color maybe. And we can also play with the look of the text detail, so you can see the different looks here. I I actually like the original look that they're going for, so I'm gonna keep it as it is. You can uncheck paint bleed, but I kind of like it. We also have the line wiggle, which will just make the text move like this. I don't like it for this example, but I definitely see use for that in different kind of videos. And animation, you can also check it on or off. So we have our title and it starts. Boom, awesome. We can even go for the project here. And we can also add a texture loop in here. Set it to screen. So we have a little bit of detail also in the background. Cool. All right, and that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and hit the notification bell if you want to stay notified when I upload new videos. Also, check out Smashworks. I will put a link in the description below. They have a really awesome pack. And yeah, it was really fun playing around with that and creating that old school look. I enjoy it so much. I hope to see you in the next one. Take care and goodbye.